Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about directional derivatives. And in this one we've been given the function f of xy equals x squared plus 2xy plus 3y squared. And we've been asked to find the directional derivative of this function at the point p, which is 2, 1, in the direction of these vectors here. So there's going to be three parts to this problem. The first is going to be to convert the vector v to a unit vector. The second will be to find the partial derivatives of f with respect to x and y. And then the third will be to combine those two pieces of information along with the point p to find the directional derivative. So first, let's talk about finding the unit vector from these vectors here, v. The way that we're going to do it is with a really simple formula, and this is the same every time. We're going to be taking the square root of the information inside these vectors here. So basically we've got the vector here, a comma b, right? We're going to be taking the square root of a squared plus b squared, like this. And if you have a vector with a, b, and c, you can do the same thing. You would just add c squared under the square root sign. But we're going to take a squared plus b squared. So in our case, that's the square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared, because both a and b are equal to 1, which simplifies to the square root of 2. So now we're going to take this value, the square root of 2, and we're going to say that the unit vector is equal to, we will take a and b, which we have as 1 and 1, and put those in the numerators, and then we're going to take the square root of 2, the value we just found, and put those in the denominators, right? And so now instead of v equals 1, 1, we have u equals 1 over the square root of 2, 1 over the square root of 2, and this is now our unit vector. So that's the first piece of information. The second is we need to take the partial derivatives of f with respect to x and y. So let's go ahead and take the partial derivative of f with respect to x. And remember, when we do that, we're treating x as the variable and holding y constant. So let's take the derivative term by term. The derivative of x squared with respect to x is going to be 2x, right? That's normal. The derivative of 2xy with respect to x will simply be 2y, because remember, if we were just taking the derivative of x on its own, the derivative of x would be 1, so we'd end up with 2y times 1, which is just going to be 2y. And the derivative of 3y squared with respect to x will just be 0, so we'll go ahead and leave it. Now let's go ahead and find the partial derivative of f with respect to y. So doing that, obviously, we'll treat y as the variable and hold x constant. So the derivative of x squared with respect to y is 0, because there's no y variable involved in this term here. The derivative of 2xy with respect to y is simply 2x, because similarly to when we took the derivative with respect to x, if we just took the derivative of y, the derivative of y with respect to y is 1, so we would have 1 times 2x. We're just left with the 2x, so the derivative of that term is 2x. The derivative of 3y squared is 6y, pretty standard. So we have these two partial derivatives. Now, the directional derivative is going to be a combination of these two pieces of information. The directional derivative is going to be denoted as d sub u of f of xy, and it's going to be equal to, we'll call these values in the unit vector here a comma b, just like we did in the vector v, but now we've got u. So the directional derivative is going to be a times the partial derivative of f with respect to x plus b times the partial derivative of f with respect to y, right? So if we plug in the information we already have into this formula, we'll get the directional derivative of fxy is going to be equal to a, which we already know is 1 over the square root of 2, times our partial derivative with respect to x, which is 2x plus 2y. Then if we add to that b, which is also 1 over the square root of 2, and multiply by the partial derivative of f with respect to y, we'll get 1 over the square root of 2 times 2x plus 6y. So that essentially is our directional derivative. But remember, we care about the directional derivative at the point P, which is 2, 1. So what we need to do is plug the point P into our directional derivative. And when we do that, we'll get d sub u for the directional derivative of f of the point 2, 1, right? So we plug that in there, and then we'll be plugging in 2 for x and 1 for y. So we'll get 1 over the square root of 2 times 2 times 2 plus 2 times 1, plugging in 2 for x and 1 for y, plus 1 over the square root of 2 times 2 times 2 plus 6 times 1. And when we simplify that, let's see what we get. D sub u f of 2, 1 is going to be equal to, we have 1 over the square root of 2 times, 2 times 2 is 4, plus, let's see, we've got here 4, plus 2 times 1 is 2, so 4 plus 2 is 6, so times 6, plus 1 over the square root of 2, going back here to our last step, 2 times 2 is 4, 6 times 1 is 6, 4 plus 6 is 10. So as you can see, we're going to get 16 over the square root of 2. Now, we could leave it like that, but it's really not proper to leave a square root in the denominator of a fraction. So what we can do to eliminate it is multiply by the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. That's just like multiplying by 1, but we'll cancel out the square root of 2 in the denominator. So when we do that, we'll get 16 times the square root of 2 divided by the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is 2, and now we can simplify 16 over 2. The 2 will cancel, and we'll just be left with 8 in the numerator, so 8 times the square root of 2. And that is our directional derivative. So this is our final answer. This is the directional derivative of the function f of xy at the point P, which is the point 2, 1, in the direction of these vectors here, 1, 1. So that's it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.